Timely Audio presents X-1, science fiction stories from Ray Bradbury, Isaac Asimov, and Poul Anderson. The original cast recordings from the original NBC radio show broadcasts.
Countdown for blast-off. X-5, -4, -3, -2, X-1. Fire. From the far horizons of the unknown come tales of new dimensions in time and space. These are stories of the future, adventures in which you'll live in a million could-be years on a thousand maybe worlds. The National Broadcasting Company presents X-1. Tonight's story, No Contact. It was in the year of 1982 that spacemen first discovered the Great Galactic Barrier. In the past 10 years, rocket travel to the moon and the nearer planets had become commonplace. And then men fixed their sights on a more distant star, the remote planet known as Volta. 5 exploratory ships went out, and none came back, each in turn disappearing mysteriously at the same vanishing point, at an invisible wall somewhere in the vast outer reaches that became known as the wrecker of spaceships, the Galactic Reef. And yet, the explorers refused to admit defeat. It was on June the 2nd, 1987... that the rocket Star Cloud made ready for takeoff, the 6th to attempt to crack the barrier and win through to Volta.
Now hear this. Condition green. 2 minutes to blast off. Condition green. 2 minutes to blast off.
Well, Lewis, this is it. I don't suppose you'll be needing the ship's doctor up here on the bridge during blast off.
I think not, Smitty. There's little chance of acceleration bends in these new overdrive ships.
I'll be in my office then, counting vitamin pills if you need me. It's only a few steps. Good luck, Lewis.
Thank you, Smitty. Lieutenant Collier.
Yes, sir?
You're relieved. You'd better get down to navigation control and take over.
Yes, sir.
Lieutenant.
Yes, sir?
We've never flown together before. This is your first flight in a space vessel as big as the Star Cloud.
Yes, sir, but I was trained in oversized jobs at the Naval Academy.
Well, if you're half as good a navigator as your father was, you'll do fine.
Thank you, sir. Did you ship out with my father?
I served under him on one of the first rocket runs to the moon.
I see.
I almost went along on his last trip to the barrier. Too bad about that.
Yes, sir.
That's all, Collier.
Lieutenant Paulison.
Get me the ground control tower on the field. I want to talk to Colonel Harrison.
Yes, sir. Go ahead, sir. I've patched in the bridge speaker.
Colonel Harrison?
Yes, Captain?
We're standing by for takeoff in 30 seconds.
Good. The field's cleared of all personnel. We'll try to reestablish radio contact immediately after takeoff. In any event, there'll be a 24-hour ground monitor.
Fine.
Good luck. Hope you make it.
Thank you. Bridge to navigation control.
Have control, Collier.
Ready, Lieutenant?
We're ready, Captain. The course is in the integrator for takeoff at 1,200 hours.
All right. Stand by for blastoff. Bridge to engine room. Fire up your rocket chambers. Take off at exactly 1,200 hours. I'll read you off. 20 seconds. 19. 18. 17. 16. Hold it. Revoke all orders. Who turned in that alarm?
This is Paulison, sir. We've uncovered a stowaway.
Stowaway? Where? Have him brought up to the bridge. Engine room, kill your rockets and stand by.
Thorson, this is Colonel Harrison in ground control. What's holding you up?
Trouble.
What's the matter with you?
What's the matter with you? There's a stowaway aboard.
Stowaway?
Yes, I thought your men were supposed to police this base. What's the matter with you?
Captain, take it easy.
You know what this delay can do to us, don't you? 1 minute later, takeoff can throw us a million miles off course. We'll have to reintegrate the whole works.
Well, look, how long do you think it'll take?
Don't bother for me for a while. I'm busy. Stupid idiot.
Captain Thorson?
Yes, come in, Smitty.
Here's your stowaway.
I'll court-martial the...
Oh,
Charlie.
Can you use a good radio man, Skipper?
Well, I see you two have met.
Met. Skipper and me made 50 trips to the moon together. Didn't we, Skipper?
Charlie, if you wanted to come along, why didn't you volunteer?
I did, Skipper. They turned me down.
Well, what's wrong with you?
Acceleration bends. They said my arteries wouldn't stand another trip.
I'm sorry to hear that.
But they're wrong, Skipper. I got one more good trip in me. Listen, Skipper, you know that these green kids, they don't know the first thing about space radio operation. Now, you put a man like me on and I'll be getting you bedtime stories from Mars.
Charlie, you know the regulations as well as I do. I can't take you, much as I'd like to.
Colonel Harrison will murder me for this.
Well, I'm sorry, Charlie. I'll have you put aground. I'll tell you what, I'll ask Harrison to put you on his ground radio contact, and it'll seem as if you're right here with us.
He won't do it, sir.
Well, he'd better. I'll have him busted to corporal for letting you sneak aboard. Look, Charlie, you better be off. Paulison.
Yes, sir.
I'm sending this man aground. Give him time to clear the launching platform.
Yes, sir.
So long, Charlie. I'm sorry.
Good luck, Skip.
I thought you were going to have him drawn and quartered.
If it had been anyone else, I would have, Smitty. But Charlie, well, he's kind of special. He's been with me since my first command when we began the regular run to the moon. And if he wanted to come along this time, well, it's only through loyalty to me.
You know, Lewis, I didn't realize it before, but you're almost human.
Captain Dawson, nav control, call you.
Oh, yes, Lieutenant. How badly are we fouled up? Can you recalculate the course, or shall I cancel the takeoff?
I've already plotted a new course on the integrator, sir. If we take off in exactly 30 seconds, we'll need to correct for only a 1 degree deflection. I can do that before we breach the stratosphere.
That's quick work. Are you sure?
Yes, sir. Positive, sir.
All right, Collier. I'm putting it in your hands. We'll blast off on your signal. Bridge to engine room. Prepare to blast off on navigator's signal. How are we doing, Collier?
Coming on the bearing, sir. That's 4, 3, 2, 0. We've intersected the course vector.
Good work, Collier.
Course is corrected, sir. We're ready to go into atomic overdrive anytime you say.
All right. Stand by.
Yes, sir.
Now hear this. Now hear this. Prepare for maximum acceleration. Bridge to engine room. Kill your rockets.
Rockets out.
Fire up number one cyclotron.
Number one ready.
Fire up number two.
Number two ready.
Withdraw your dampening rods.
Fission chamber ready. Blast tubes cleared. All generators operating at capacity. Take it over, sir.
Go into overdrive at the count of zero. 3 seconds, Mr. Collier.
Three.
Two.
Two.
One.
One.
Zero.
Zero.
How are we doing, Collier?
On course, sir. She's running hot and true.
My compliments, Lieutenant. This job would have done your father credit, and he was the best navigation officer I ever saw.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Start your gyros. Put her on robot control. All right, the bridge is yours, Mr. Collier. If you need me, I'll be in Dr. Smithson's office.
Yes, sir.
Well, Lewis, I see you got us off the ground.
You can thank young Collier for that. Chip off the old block.
You knew his father?
As a matter of fact, I knew him very well. First-rate spaceman.
Oh, is he the one
Yes. He was lost in the galactic barrier on the second ship we sent out to Volden.
Lewis, just what do you think this galactic barrier is?
Oh, your guess is as good as mine, Doc. All I know is that 5 ships have gone into it, and none of them have come back out.
You think it's a nit? How about Mestrovic's theory that it's a time warp in space? That the ships reach it and slip into another dimension?
I think that's a lot of rubbish. My theory is that the galactic barrier is nothing more than a radioactive layer of some kind.
Why do you say that?
Well, we know that radar signals bounce off it like they were hitting an invisible glass wall. And we know that it destroys our ships and crews in some way. There's no other logical explanation.
What makes you think we can get through it, Lewis?
Because we're ready for it. The others weren't. The entire hull of this ship is completely shielded with lead. we can crack through any radioactive cloud ever detected.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.